Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. It is now officially Sakura and Hanami season. The Japan Weather Association finally announced the start of Sakura season a couple days ago. Sakura, or cherry blossoms, are a huge deal in Japan and they are a symbol of spring. It is an extremely festive time in Japan and people partake in Hanami, which is just sitting around and enjoying the blossoms. Usually people will get together and hang out under the trees and bring food and bring drinks and like picnic and really just enjoy themselves and really enjoy the blossoms. There are all different kinds of sakura trees that range in like deeper pinks to ones that are almost pure white, and they are so beautiful. As the petals fall down, it almost looks like snow. It's really a surreal experience. It's absolutely gorgeous. Typically, sakura blossoms do not live very long. From bud to start falling off the tree, it's about a week, so it's not very long. And also, when they bloom depends on the weather. So it does change every year. Usually in Tokyo, it blooms usually around end of March, beginning of April-ish. But they do offer a sakura forecast every year, so they guesstimate sort of when it's gonna actually start blooming. This year, the blooms in Tokyo actually started quite early. I would say it's about a week earlier than average. Along with the beautiful flowers, there are always, in true Japanese fashion, themed goods, foods, drinks, and everything else to get you in the Hanami vibe. A good example of this: every year, Starbucks Japan does a limited edition sakura themed line. They also have lines in other parts of Asia like Singapore and Korea. They sell out insanely fast. They're super limited edition and it's really actually hard to get your hands on some, and they will go on eBay and people will jack up the price to like hundreds of dollars for like plastic. This year I was really lucky to get my hands on this one thanks to Ruby. As far as sakura in food, sakura does not have its own real flavor necessarily. It is a flower, and flowers sort of taste like nothing. If you just pick a sakura blossom off a tree and eat it, it's probably gonna taste like a plant. However, Japanese people do salt them and pickle them, which gives it flavor, or sometimes they put it in a sweet syrup, which also brings out flavor. Today, I put together a variety of sakura-themed foods so that way you can see sort of what you can get during sakura season. I'm gonna be doing a savory item, which is sakura soba. Soba are buckwheat noodles, and they are very popular in Japan and pretty good for you. So these have sakura infused into the noodles. So I've never had sakura soba before. I've had like matcha and other types of infused soba, yuzu soba, but I've never had sakura, so I'm excited to try it. So I put the noodles into tsuyu, which is the soup base. And I'm gonna try it. Itadakimasu. It's good. Tastes a lot like normal soba, but it has a very slight sweet hint. I thought it would sort of lean on the salty route, but I guess since the tsuyu is usually pretty salty, they decided to take it a little sweeter. I think I'm gonna try it without the tsuyu as well. Yeah, it's good. It's a bit lighter than normal soba. Definitely recommend this. Next, I'm gonna do wagashi, which are traditional Japanese sweets, and there are a lot, obviously, that are sakura themed. So this is a sakura waffle. It is sort of like an osembe or rice cracker, I think, on the outside, and then inside it looks like cream. It smells super sweet and it smells a lot like sakura, and it's really pink, it's cute. So I'm gonna try it. Itadakimasu. It's good. So this is sort of more like a cookie with cream inside. You can't taste the cream too much. It's mostly the cookie. I mean, I think the cookie and the cream are the same flavor. It's not overly sweet considering how sweet it smells and looks. Another wagashi is the sakura goromo, which is a bean cake. So inside it has azuki or red bean, and the outside is sort of like a crepe. This one also has a dried sakura on top of it. It actually smells like sakura mochi, like slightly salted, but... Itadakimasu. Mmm! That's why. It smells like sakura mochi because inside this has a pickled leaf, a pickled cherry tree leaf, which sakura mochi has wrapped around it. So it is that salty flavor, and then it has the slight sweetness of the azuki, and the outside actually is sort of pancakey. It doesn't really taste like much. If you're not that into sweets, this one's probably good for you. So now I'm gonna show some more modern treats. And this one is sakura miruki. Miruki, or milky, is a super popular Japanese sweet. Usually they're like little round milk candies, and these are sakura flavored. I grew up eating Miruki and really love the originals and some of the other flavors that they've come out with, but I've never had the sakura one, so hopefully it's good. Usually the insides are white, but this one's pink. Itadakimasu. You have to wait for them to melt and get soft a little before you can chew them. It's actually pretty strong in flavor. This one's pretty good. I think I prefer the original though. The next is Country Mam Kantori Mamu Sakura Cookies. I would say Country Mam is similar to like Chips Ahoy, where they have a bunch of different kinds of flavors. So Country Mam also is a cookie company. They have like chocolate chip, and this is a seasonal one, sakura. Ooh, it smells super good. These are not crispy cookies, they're a bit chewy and soft. This one's pink. The inside of these are yellow. They're really good. They're actually really strong in flavor, not as mild as I thought, but I like it a lot. And aside from food, you can also get drinks that are sakura flavored and themed. So for example, at Starbucks, they offer sakura frappuccino, and there's also places that serve sakura tea, sakura latte, sakura milk tea, a whole bunch of stuff. So I got a sakura frappuccino. This one is not from Starbucks, but it has a pretty pickled sakura flower on the top and looks pretty intense, to be honest. Itadakimasu. It's sweet. It's a bit too sweet, but it's really good. So the place I got this from, Oko Cafe, also has sakura honey boba. So it's sakura honey, and then they soak the boba in it, which is really good. They also have sakura an taiyaki. So they have the taiyaki, which is a little fish-shaped, you know, sort of pancake thing. Inside it has sakura anko, which is sakura and red bean. Yeah, so they have lots of sakura-flavored stuff here. They also have like sakura lattes and stuff like that, but I got this one because it's pretty. Yeah, it's not terrible. Sakura season in Japan is very, very magical, so I highly recommend heading over if you ever have a chance. Let me know how you guys enjoy hanami in the comments, or also if there's other sakura flavored drinks or snacks that you love. I would love to hear about it so I could try it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Mata ne!